So I had been looking at this Tambour door for some time, thinking I'd like to get it replaced. I guess being 20 years old, it had served for a good amount of time, but it was starting to bulge from things being inside, since we're not using it for a TV, but other things. And in the top, the laminate was coming off. It's kind of like a wood surface, but it's not solid wood slats. It's got some kind of a paper product almost, it looks like, under there. And then down in the bottom right-hand corner, the handle was also lifting and coming loose. So, to remove the door, you have to take the bottom out. You've got two slide outs there, and down in the right-hand corner, you see the metal slides. Inside that is a tab on each side. Mine had a engraving that said push it one direction, but I found that it came loose if I pushed one up and the other one down. But just push on them and pull until it comes loose, and then there's one extra bump pull on it and it comes out. There's still a block on the left hand beside there under the little cabinets. If you stick your head inside that cabinet, you'll see, looking down, a strip of metal with two screws in it. You remove those two screws, and that block of wood comes out too. So now the door will come down and drop right out the bottom. But before we do so, I wanted to show here the door goes across the top of the cabinets and down the back. And you can see it coming down the back of that large cabinet opening. And if you have things in there like we do, instead of the TV, it can hit those things and the door won't come clear open. You can see the grooves that comes down in on the right and the left there. Quarter inch plywood cut exactly the right size, a little tight. Put glue around the edges and then pressed it firmly into place just in front of those grooves to protect the door from stuff getting underneath it so it can open completely. But if you notice up there in the top, there is another cabinet, the littler one there, cabinet opening, and it also is open in the back. Very easy for things to slide back and get in the way of the door opening clear up. So I made another piece of quarter inch plywood exactly the right size, real tight. Placed glue around it and pushed it in there. Got my finger up the cord hole in the back of that cabinet to help stop where I want it to be in front of the grooves so that the door won't hit that new back. But that'll protect it from things sliding back. I ripped my new slats from solid oak stock from the edge of the stock that I bought from Home Depot, red oak. I made them a quarter of an inch thick, which is thicker than the original ones, but I wanted it stronger. Not only will they be solid wood, so they'll be stronger, I made them a little thicker, and they still fit the slots in the cabinet. But I also made them a 3/32 of an inch fatter than a quarter of an inch to have some room for sanding, etc. So here I am sanding the edges because they're a little splintery. Get the edges nice and rounded. I chose not to bevel the edges like the original one so that the surface will be fairly flat. It'll show the grooves of the slats, but it won't have those beveled edges. I laid the slats out on my countertop, choosing the best side lying face down, and I put a block clamped to the left side to line up that edge. And then I put a square on the opposite corner, make sure that when you get done lining up the one straight edge, you want them all square. Otherwise, they're not going to slide up and down the grooves properly. And once they're square, then I clamp a block on the top and on the bottom to hold them in place and press them together to try to keep the slats right up against each other so that glue wouldn't ooze down between them too easily. The backing of the old one was a white canvas, but they had edges on them. Glued, they were the same laminate as the surface of the door on the outside, evidently to make it slick. It would be smoother to slide up and down the groove than the canvas would. I chose not to put an edge on it, but I cut my canvas, and black was the only thing available at the time in Walmart, under $6 a yard. But I cut mine the right length to fit the door, but I also cut them about an eighth to a quarter of an inch short so that the canvas would not be riding up and down in the grooves. It would be bare wood, which I thought would not hang up as much. And I also did something else I'll show at the end here. So then I lifted the bottom edge of the canvas and used a paintbrush to put on glue. This is just normal wood glue. It's I used Tight Bond number 2 because I happened to have a gallon of it, and it seemed to work very well. After brushing it on, then I pushed the canvas back down and used a miniature paint roller, which was dry, to press the canvas down onto the wood nice and firmly. After that, then I peeled the top of the canvas back down toward the bottom until it exposed where the wood was wet with glue, and then put on more glue, maybe 4, 5, 6 slats at a time. And once that was all glued up, then I moved the canvas back up, laid it down, and then ran the roller up and down it. I found that if I went sideways, it tended to move the canvas left and right, but I still did it to push it down. And then I did rolling up and down where I could do it a little bit more firmly and did not slide the canvas over the wet glue. So I kept on going 4, 5, 6 slats at a time, pulled the canvas down to where it was glued, spread new glue on, a few more slats, and then pulled the canvas back up and rolled it down tight until I got to the top. I used a straight edge and a sharp blade in my box cutter to trim the end, both ends of the canvas, so that I didn't have fuzzy edges sticking out. After the glue had set up for a bit, still only about an hour, I turned it over carefully and sanded the face. Including the edges to make them smooth and make them slide a little bit easier. And then I pulled it over the edge of my bench and blew out the sawdust from the grooves, but that also gave me a chance to find any slats that were stuck with glue between them so that they did not bend well. Pulled them across the edge and then tapped on it with my hand so that it wouldn't completely dry that way. So after the glue is set up and dried, I did the stain. I used golden oak stain, which seemed to match as close as I could to the oak that was in the Roadtrek. After brushing the surface, wiping off extra, I rolled it loosely and set it on edge so that I could then brush stain into the cracks. When the stain was dried, I took the old handle from the old door, glued up the back of it, and clamped it onto the bottom two slats. After the glue had time to dry, I turned the door upside down and stapled with my pneumatic gun through the back into the handle, because the handle gets a lot of use, sometimes kind of hard pulling. The original was done, glued, and stapled, and I thought that made it extra strong. My black canvas showed dust, but it's not going to show in the finished product anyway. Cleaned it off a bit, and then turned it back over and compared it again with the original. Even though between the wood and my stain I used, the new one looks a little darker, I think it looks just fine when it was installed, but it certainly looks nice. Now, before installing the new door, I got out my heat gun and an old candle and warmed up the wood a bit, and then rubbed the candle along the top edge where it'll fit into the groove and along the end. I turned it over and made sure that there was wax along the backside where it fits into the groove also. Now back to the RT before installing the door. I'll throw this one in free. A little extra. The 12-volt jacks that are in the back of that cabinet, which were for 12-volt audio-visual equipment, I liked having that available, but if you stuff it full of stuff, like we do, you can't reach it. So I put in this extension cord, coiled extension cord, and put it through the hole so it comes out below at the foot of the bed. So I can use it for things like a telephone charger or whatever, fan. And when it's not in use, I just stuff it up into stuff the socket up into the hole, and it holds it quite nicely. Can pull it out when needed. Okay, we bring in the new door. To install it, rolled up so that it lays on the bed, and then insert it into the grooves on both sides and pull it up into place. When your hand doesn't fit in the top anymore, the bottom is stiff enough when it's pulled uncurled to just push up on it and put it right up into place. Another little hint for free: if the door seems to jam a little bit, it doesn't slide very smoothly, and you think that the edges maybe need to be shortened a little bit. I did this once, pulled it back out, rolled it up, and then set it on edge on my belt sander, and just shaved the ends just a little bit, and put more wax on it again, and then put it back in, and it slid much nicer. You get the two screws in the block on the left back into place, and you're ready to put the sliding door drawers back in the bottom. Just stick it in the slots and press until it goes into place, clear to the back. Pull the door back down into its closed position and enjoy your handiwork.